Well, you can't have a conversation about the greatest keyboard players in the history of rock without talking about former Yes and Moody Blues pianist Patrick Moraz. Amazing player and a most memorable personality. And get this, he believes the three most important ingredients to a great song are the same as to a great life: spontaneity, experimentation, and improvisation. Let's get Bolder Backstage with Patrick Moraz.
Patrick.
Yeah.
How are you?
Fantastico. Unbelievable, man.
Watching Patrick Moraz play is an unusual experience. You never know what you're going to hear, as he often makes melodies up on the fly. And as fast as his hands are, his mind is just as quick. A conversation with Moraz is an amusement park ride of consciousness, wit, and wisdom.
I've had the great fortune, in a way, to be free enough to stay not only healthy, but alive, and alive with my mind, and not be inhibited or forbidden by some tasks or some rules or something. I still respect, of course, the rules of the game, you know, especially in music, you know. But as I always said, you know, music is music, and conversely, music is music.
And music has been his path to a pretty interesting life. He joined the band Yes in 1974, taking the place of the legendary Rick Wakeman. He was a great fit. Everyone was excited about the possibilities until it ended just 2 years later when Wakeman decided to come back. Eventually, Moraz took his wall of keyboards to the Moody Blues, where he continued to make a real connection with the audience.
Some of my very best times on stage and playing the music with Yes, and playing, of course, with Moody Blues, with whom I was for 13 years, you know.
But your time with Yes, when you replace a legend, people don't want to like you yet. Yes, fans say that what you did with Relayer was wonderful.
I think they have a very good taste, you know. And of course, Yes was always one of my favorite bands since they started in 50 years ago.
One of the reasons Moraz has been able to survive in the music industry all these years is his ability to do what he's doing right now at an astonishing level, improvising.
I don't only play music or compose music. I mean, I've composed maybe more than 3,000 pieces of music so far, but I still do, and I still improvise as well, and I'm still able to compose in real time some music at any given time. See, that's it.
He says he believes the key for any of us to be truly creative is to not be afraid to use your brain, your entire brain.
It's so easy to have the two parts of one's brain communicate, you know, with the two sides by doing some very, very simple kind of things which I've developed, of course, over the years. And then also not be inhibited by exploring. Voilà, that's it. That's the exploration of, you know, new musical or artistic territories, you know.
Perhaps most remarkable is that his desire to explore, whether we're talking about music or life, is just as strong as ever.
How old are you now?
Oh, I'm gonna be 74 in 3 weeks, actually, you know.
Look at you. Look at your energy. Look at your passion. Did you ever think that this is the way you would be at 74?
I've never really thought about it, actually, you know.
You don't feel 74, do you?
No.
It's interesting, the way you look at your music is also the way you live your life. What the next day is going to bring, it's another adventure. It's more unknown. It's the curiosity as to what's to come. What do you think the takeaway is? What can we learn from what you know about life?
Since I come from Switzerland originally, the peace and the coexistence has always played an immense role in my creativity, because the epitome of creativity lies in the state of dynamic tension between extreme forces in opposition. And the more extreme the forces, the more the creativity is happening.
So what you're saying is not to fear the tension.
Right. Exactly.
Not to fear the tough times that we have, because from that comes our next great composition.
Yeah, yeah. Man, yeah, I tell you what, man, you understand everything, huh? Yeah.
You're a great teacher.
It's fantastic. You have understood everything. You know, it's fantastic to have your questions and to be able to talk about all this like that.
Boy, the chance to explore the thoughts of someone like Patrick Moraz is always a mind-opening experience. And his advice, just like he does in music, keep creating, keep reaching for new challenges, and never stop thinking.